I am delighted to be presenting on behalf of the RUA Life Science Group. Moving past the usual disclaimer side, as you've said, we are a cardiovascular business. We focus on enabling our own medical devices with our proprietary polymer Elast-EonTM, as well as licensing and manufacturing for third parties. We were formed in April 2020 when the contract manufacturing business of RUA Medical Devices merged with the IP licensing business of AorTech International. Over the last 3 years, the business has been transformed into a fully fledged medical device manufacturer in our own right. And we operate out of three sites in Ayrshire. And since formation of the group, we have doubled the workforce, our current employee base now 43 and growing. There are four businesses within the group, all exploiting the group's polymer technology. Firstly, RUA Biomaterials, which holds the Elast-EonTM IP and licenses Elast-EonTM to the medical device industry. RUA's contract manufacturing division conducts all the R&D for the group, as well as providing contract manufacturing services to third parties. RUA Vascular is involved in the development and commercialization of a graft pipeline, with shareholder value maximized by growing this business through a distribution model to achieving attractive levels of profitability. And finally, RUA Structural Heart, who are the innovators behind our polymeric heart valve technology platform, who are positioning themselves for an exit when valuations are attractive prior to launch. Supporting the business, we have a credible leadership team who have a wealth of experience in the field of cardiovascular devices with world-leading organisations. So let's focus on each of the business units in greater detail, starting with RUA Biomaterials. First of all, why is Elast-EonTM so important? Next to deep space, the human body is the most aggressive environment that materials can be subjected to. Being able to resist the body's inbuilt defense mechanisms and withstand complex movements, it's critical for any medical implant. Elast-EonTM has been designed to work in combination with the body's complex systems and is a high performance medical copolymer of silicon and polyurethane. The key is its biostability when used in long-term implants that are blood contacting, and it's been used worldwide in over 8 million life-sustaining implants over the last 15 years. We are positioning Elast-EonTM to de-risk the future of all animal-based cardiovascular medical devices. Current risks of using animal tissue in medical devices include cross-species contamination. There's supply chain risks. There's only two countries worldwide which have the capability to supply BSE-free animal tissue for medical devices. And there are environmental risks of breeding livestock for medical purposes. And this generates significant greenhouse gases, and they consume large proportions of the world's crops, and by inference, fresh water, fertilisers and pesticides. RUA Biomaterials is performing well ahead of expectations. The royalty income from sales and licensing fees have shown good steady growth year on year and high net profit margins. Future strategy is centred around growth of royalty income and continuing to enhance the IP portfolio. And since it's akin to an annuity business, if we use an annuity model on, say, a 7% yield basis, business valuation could be as high as £6 million. The second of our business units is RUA Medical, and it's through the contract manufacturing business unit. This business designs and manufactures implantable medical devices for the entire RUA group and third parties within the life science industry. Like RUA Biomaterials, it's also a very profitable cash generative business and has had an outstanding year with increased revenues and net profit margins. And a recent purchase of the building adjacent to our current Irvine head office has increased our footprint by around 40%. And this provides us with a facility for scaled up commercial manufacturing of vascular grafts. The growth drivers this year have included the signing of a new contract with a multinational business for the supply of medical device components, increased demand from our major customer, as well as price increases. And we actually changed our business model last year to ensure we focused on our business development activities on long-term strategic opportunities. And we are delighted that we now have an opportunity pipeline with RFQ values of approximately £2 million in annualised revenue. In terms of valuation for this business unit, the contract manufacturing industry has always been seen as a prudent choice for return on investment, with valuations of up to 20 times EBITDA being achieved. And we have used a conservative 10 times EBITDA to value this business at £8.5 million. Moving on to RUA Vascular. This is one of our pre-revenue businesses focused on the development and commercialization of vascular grafts. And we believe we've got a real opportunity to become a significant player in the open surgical polyester graft market, a total addressable market of nearly £750 million. Polyester grafts are used to repair or replace damaged and diseased vessels of the aorta, and that's the largest blood vessel that carries blood from the heart to the body via the abdomen. The graft market is dominated by two key players. They're both using nearly 40-year-old technology, and they use materials of animal origin as a coating to seal their woven grafts. Our grafts are coated with Elast-Eon, and the first products to be launched are large bore straight and root grafts, which can command ASPs ranging from £700 to over $3,000. And these large bore grafts will be the enabler for development of more complex products in the portfolio, such as the frozen elephant trunk, and that can sell for up to $32,000 in the States. Looking at Terumo's gel weave device, they use gelatin as a sealant. So our goal is to design a graft that is substantially equivalent to this predicate device, yet also prove that there are many benefits of using Elast-Eon as a sealant. In vivo data that we have collected to date has shown that fibrin growth, which occurs as part of the natural healing process, completely encapsulates the outside of our graft. We believe this could give rise to clinical benefits. However, this difference in the healing process has driven the requirement for a pre-submission with the FDA. Throughout the last 12 months, this process has enabled us to agree the preclinical in vivo study requirements. We have confirmed that we can continue to use the less onerous 510k route to market clearance, and we have also agreed a clinical trial design with the FDA's clinical trial reviewers. And there's only one more outstanding minor statistical issue, which we expect to resolve imminently. The total investment in this business to date is around £3 million, which has gotten us to an advanced regulatory stage with our large bore grafts, as well as promising in vivo data and an established graft pilot line. We also have a clear and achievable route to market for these products as a result of a recently signed global distribution deal with Corsum, who are a global medical device company focused on the structural heart area. And they have sales channels into cardiothoracic surgeons in over 100 countries. So full market penetration of our graft pipeline, sales are predicted to be in the region of £73 million. And finally, RUA Structural Heart. We're looking to transform the 8 billion surgical, aortic and transcatheter heart valve market. The focus initially is on development of a leaflet system in an aortic valve, and the leaflets are the three flaps in the middle of the valve in the photo on the left. There are currently two types of valves in use: mechanical valves, which often last for the remainder of a patient's life without replacement, but the patient needs long-term anticoagulants to minimise the risk of stroke, and biological valves, which are derived from bovine pericardium and which start to fail as soon as they are implanted due to the stresses on the leaflets or calcification, particularly in younger patients. So they rarely last longer than 12 to 15 years. Our lead leaflet design is that of a polymeric composite material that will restore the patient's quality of life without the repeated valve failures and lifelong use of anticoagulants. So the total business investment to date has been around $1.5 million. It's put RUA on the map. Polymeric heart valves are the future, and RUA has been mentioned in these discussions. Our lead valve design has a composite leaflet that is strong and flexible, and is designed which is optimised to minimise stress. And the one company that we do know of that are developing polymeric surgical heart valves was valued at £120 million at the stage of first in man. So at the right stage with the right product, there's no reason why we shouldn't enjoy a similar valuation. So to conclude, we are building a business for the long term that will deliver high rewards. We have a balanced portfolio with two cash generating business units showing good growth and a healthy valuation. And we have a clear roadmap for development and commercialisation of our innovative products that have the potential to be truly disruptive in the marketplace. Thank you very much for listening, and please, any questions? Happy to answer.
I tell you what, I'm chuckling because I enjoyed something I saw on one of your slides. Feedback include the word awesome. Awesome. It says it all, doesn't it? But I'm also wondering, you know, animal tissue for medical devices, has it now served its purpose and it is ripe to be phased out?
I mean, obviously COVID has had a huge impact on it, and the world is changing, and not only are device manufacturers realising this, but regulators are too. So therefore Elast-EonTM is in the perfect position as an enabling technology to de-risk the future of all current animal-based medical devices. So yes.
So double awesome then. 43 employees and growing. So how would you describe your recruitment drive? Because often the pace of recruitment is a big clue about the health of the business overall.
Yes, not just recruitment, but I think our, you know, and many companies will agree with me, people strategy is their number one priority at the moment. It's the people that make a business. So we're not just looking at how we recruit people, we're looking at how we retain them. And that includes, you know, building a very positive culture and making sure that our competitive pay and benefits as well. And we are lucky in Ayrshire, reasonably close to Glasgow, with a fantastic aerospace engineering facility based at Prestwick Airport. So there is a nice cluster of not just aerospace, but technical and pharma companies around us.
I just need a little bit more colour around the transformational distribution agreement with, how do I say the company's name? Corsim.
Corsim, yes.
Corsim. So are there all sorts of little caveats? Are you waiting for FDA approval, or is revenue going to be generated almost immediately?
Of course, we're really excited by the Corsim deal. We think it's a great deal, and feedback from our colleagues in the cardiovascular industry, they're telling us it's an amazing deal as well. For us, it's low cost and it's low risk expenditure. So we produce devices for distribution, for which we receive payment from Corsum at cost. And in the spirit of a true partnership, we shared the gross margin achieved on global sales on a 50-50 basis. Because Corsum are not currently in aortic repair, there's no risk of Corsum doing this deal to stop our grafts from being launched, and having access to their proven global sales team and existing sales infrastructure, I think not just totally de-risks our route to market, it's clear it's achievable, but it's just such a huge validation of our vascular graft portfolio by a global player in the cardiovascular industry. So we need to get our head down and really achieve the regulatory clearances that we require.
Okay, finally, so you are being recognised by your peers. You've been congratulated on that deal by the network. I'm just wondering, will there be other deals of that nature? Or are you just going to focus on the FDA approval at the moment?
The Corsum deal at this stage only includes our large bore straight and root grafts. We have an additional graft pipeline that includes medium bore branch and FET grafts. So it leaves us free to decide on how to commercialise these grafts. And of course, we have our heart valve product pipeline also. So we're looking at all avenues to maximise returns for shareholders.
Very good. And then we will hear that double awesome. Dr. Caroline Stretton from RUA Life Sciences, it's been lovely seeing you again. Take care.
Thank you. Bye.